Being petty doesn't come from nowhere. There's always something that sparks it. Trashterpiece Theater mini episode, The Genesis of Petty Perry.
So when I was little, my mom used to send me to camp every summer for weeks at a time. I used to think it was for my benefit, but come to find out, she just wanted to send me away to live her best life during the summer. This one year, I was at Camp Timberlake blossoming into a young tater thot since I never went through a girls are icky stage. I bagged the cutest girl in camp, Amira, who happened to be 2 years older than I was. My friends were excited for us. The counselors were excited for us, but apparently the older boys in camp wasn't feeling that shit. Especially Taj, Kevin, and Eddie. Taj had a big crush on Amira, and Kevin and Eddie were his lackeys. Instead of congratulating the young player, they started bullying me. They used to dunk me at the pool, throw things at me when no one was looking, and used to mess with me in the cafeteria when no counselors were around. They were bigger than me, so there wasn't much I could do to them physically, and they outnumbered me. I mean, I had friends, but they weren't about their life. They just kept trying to get me to tell somebody. So my options were to take it on the chin or snitch. Neither option worked well for me, so I created a third. I got calculated. During the week, since they were older, we slept in different cabins. But on the weekends, all the boys slept out in the forest in tents. I didn't know how I was going to get them back, but I knew that would be the time. I figured it out quick, too. The counselors brought food and snacks with us, but we were supposed to drink water straight from the creek since it was pure spring water. So I waited for Taj, Crab, and Goyle to get thirsty, and when they did, I quietly followed them to the spring. When they sat down at the bank, I walked upstream. When they started to drink and fill their bottles, I peed into the water so it would float downstream to where they were drinking. Every time they walked down to the creek, I followed them and peed in the water upstream from them. Every time they drank, they quenched their thirst with some North Philly pee. And they never knew. I never said anything. Not even to my friends. Just sat back and enjoyed my silent revenge. They still talk shit during the week, but I knew I got the best of them. I got the girl, and they spent weekends drinking cold mountain spring urine. That was enough. What's wild is, it wasn't the last time I peed on something to get revenge. To be continued. Thank you so much for watching Trashterpiece Theater. Please like, comment, follow, and subscribe. Also, please consider donating to our Patreon to help the channel grow. Patreon patrons receive additional bonus episodes, so there's that too. This is all possible because of your support. Thank you.